Smith is entitled to get a written status to send her support cancellation. All of your contestants are though. If you want the competition to happen, you need new contestants immediately. The fate of Easton's finest is in your hands. Okay, I'll go to the boss.
Where's my finest suit? Definitely weren't lying tonight.
That's for sure. If this is how the group is opening up, I cannot wait to see what else they've got in store.
Me too. Well, everyone, welcome to Easton's Finest 2023.
Welcome, welcome. We're glad you're all joining us to watch our 13 not-so-talented contestants compete for Easton's Finest this year.
My name, Olivia Stevens. Hold on, sorry. My name, Mary Cross, and I'm joined by
Olivia Stevens,
Amelia Andre,
and Bia Nasser.
And tonight, we will be your hosts.
So, buckle up. And before we begin, we'd like to introduce our lovely judges.
Yes.
They may have been forced to be here, but please welcome six of your own own Allhurriums teachers.
Starting off, we have, you guys know her as the best OA women's basketball coach of all time, the leading lady wandering the halls with a pushcart carrying all her belongings, and the lady that will always give you a smile when you need her most, Mrs. Holbrook!
Next up, we have the man who hands out the worst financial advice, the fearless leader of the OA JV boys hockey squad, and the fierce defender of the finance bathroom. Please welcome Mr. Cahill.
From some random school in Cambridge, Havard, I think it's
something
called.
Something like that.
Yeah. Our very own Wolf of Wall Street, Mr. Flaherty.
Next up, we have one of my personal inspirations and a newly graduated middle schooler, Mr. Dyer. Couldn't handle him down there, could you, Mr. Dyer? Honestly, I couldn't blame you.
And finally, our last judge, Mrs. Schleicher, or should I say, Mrs. Newly Engaged. Thanks for joining us after your little getaway. Where was our invite? Could you at least show us the rock, please? All right, everyone, without further ado, we're going to start off tonight's festivities with our intro and sport category. Thank you.
To start off our night of various activities, please give a warm welcome to Rique Oliveira. Rique is a joyful little bean who loves helping the less fortunate. Growing up in the Brazilian slums, he had to resort to crime. After stealing the moon and becoming the most despicable man in South America, Rique was forced to flee and move to the suburbs of Easton. He then began his career as a professional Fortnite player. All was going well until he grew excessively overweight and spent all of his earnings on food and V-Bucks. Nowadays, Rique can be spotted driving the battle bus, giving free scenic tours to Easton elderly, and doing really fun activities with his buddies at Bronson's house. He would like to thank Russ Burnham, his friends, and his massive family of 57 who are watching from home. He's now here to prove his worth as Easton's finest. Thank you, Rique. Rumor has it, Mary, that Gru went as Rique for Halloween.
I hope he gives the moon back. All right, next to stage, we have Michael Jambuso. Since a very young age, Michael Jambuso has been like other boys. He has never been afraid to eat broccoli, try new things, and meet new people. Michael uses his Sigma grind set to accomplish his goals and to live his life at peak performance. His immense work ethic still goes unrevealed to this day. Procrastination is not in this man's vocabulary. Michael is able to perfect the perfect handshake tip, also known as the golden handshake. The handshake tip is when you shake someone's hand with simultaneously passing them a sum of money to ensure a peak performance. His mother loves him more than her other two sons. Despite all of his achievements, Mr. Jambuso only has one goal in life. That goal is to make people smile and dance to his tasty music. He wants to see people standing, moving, and grooving. While he is performing, nothing else seems to have mattered to him. Michael only hopes that the audience will feel the same way. Thank you, Michael. Maybe you can teach me and Olivia a lesson on how to do the proper handshake and also how to become our parents' favorite child.
Well done, thank you. Entering the stage, we have Andrew. Andrew Zagami, better known as Zoo, is a local guy who spends most of the time at the villa. He also plays baseball and was named captain. Although he spends more time announcing the games than playing in them, he swears he can hit it to Sweden. He just needs to be given the chance. Andrew owns a landscaping company, which is most known for the sweatshirts that he gives out. Shout out Zagami Landscaping. He spends most of the day reliving his glory as freshman year quarterback after he quit to pursue grass. You can typically find him driving around with his trailer just because he thinks it looks cool in the OA parking lot, or spending time at Bronson's house doing fun activities. When he can, Andrew always befriends the younger kids so he can make sure that they have a good role model. He wants to thank his family, friends, the Battle Bus, Russ Burnham, and especially Mr. Cahill, who gave him the confidence to do this after telling him he can do it. Zoo is most proud of the fact that he has not eaten goldfish in 3 years and counting due to a $5 bet. He hopes to win Easton's Finest to prove to all of his haters that he can say the letter R. Thank you, Zoo, and my mom appreciates that deal you cut.
Coming on next, we have Olivia Stone. Olivia Stone is part of the... Wait, okay, she's actually not part of any sport. Actually, unless you count the 2 years when she played softball and was afraid of the ball. And when she got last place in the Moscato Mile, 3 times in a row. But at least she can... Wait, actually no, she still can't do a cartwheel. Okay, well, at least she can ride a scooter. Look at her go. Anyways, Olivia is an avid theater kid who loves to sing love songs in a room at 9 p.m. She knows how to play the piano, ukulele, and the kazoo. She has said that she would love to win Easton's Finest because she thinks it would be hilarious to win a male pageant and shove it in history's face. Also, the prom tickets are a huge plus because she likes to dress up and look pretty.
Thank you, Olivia. B-Mitch, come on out here. For our next contestant, standing at a solid 5'2", some people call him by the names of Rizzosaurus, Rizzly Bear, or B-Mitch. When he's not destroying every Chipotle burrito in sight, ending up on the mom's Facebook page, or not repping your dad's Max, he's at Easton's Finest. Brian prides himself on the fact that he is the number one most visited barista in Massachusetts. Brian's special touch on each drink he crafts makes them turn out a little worse than expected. Brian has also been consistent in aiding to the class of 2023's success by winning multiple dance battles over the years. He's only made immense improvements. If Brian could have three wishes, they would consist of the ability to meet the height requirement of any roller coaster at Six Flags, be able to touch the ground when he sits in a chair, and to be able to fight the urge to not find everything funny. If Brian is not in the gym, he is practicing for Easton's Finest in order to bury the competition tonight. I present to you Brian Mitchell.
That was definitely something. Just so you all know, we had to waive the height requirement in order for him to participate. Thank you, Brian. Now please welcome Colby Tower. Colby Tower is a retired basketball player, but still cooks, scrubs, and senior rec. He has worked a number of jobs in high school, such as bagging groceries at the Big Y, and even an Uber Eats driver. That was until he was fired for stealing Chipotle's guac recipe. He single-handedly has put the bluefin tuna on the endangered species list for eating so many spicy tuna rolls. Hold up, Olivia. Is that why Chino's been sold out for the past month? If you ever wonder why he smells so bad, it's because he refuses to shower until COVID is over. Ooh, sorry, Sophia. He spends his days setting sail on the Vita Grotta, and his winter is locked in Jack Perrin's basement. When he graduates, he plans to do a victory lap with Bill Matthews in his monumental golf cart. Colby would like to thank Celine Dion for always inspiring him to sing, and he'd like to wish the best of luck to his fellow competitors. Thanks, Colby.
Rumor has it, Colby sang a duet live with Celine Dion on the deck of Vita Grotta. Anyways, next on the stage, we have Will Burke. Will is an outstanding young boy who loves to give back to his community by working at Taco Bell and serving soup at the homeless shelter. His favorite soup is Campbell's chicken noodle, which he loves to slurp up with the boys. After he drives off in his 5-accident-deep Chevy Equinox, he loves to play peaceful music, which consists of Kevin Gates, DJ Khaled, NBA Youngboy, and Ice Spice. I guess you could say he enjoys being called a munch. Will has always been the class clown and loves to be a bit silly and goofy. He loves drinking his juice pouches and eating his fruit snacks so his sugar stays up. He always makes sure, his friends always make sure little Willie has his med kit on him. Will just hopes that he can give everybody a good time and make everybody laugh. Wonderful. Thank you so much, Will. Hopefully that practice in the bathroom mirror earlier helped.
And let's hope his sugar levels stay up. We definitely don't want anyone passing out on stage. All right, our next contestant is Victor Ramiro. Victor thinks he is the most superior 5'5 male to walk the halls of OA. He is widely known through OA as the King of Oklahoma Drills. In Victor's free time, he enjoys wrestling sweaty men and trying to find the talent for this show. You might not know Victor because he was a privileged private school boy for quite some time. He prided himself on attending an SEC school, but was quickly humbled. He dreamed of being a volunteer, but now focuses on being a lifelong landscaper. If you can't find him in the wrestling room, he's probably on the treadmill cutting the food he was not supposed to eat before this. Victor would like to thank Todd Texera for being his garage buddy. If Victor wins, he plans to put his earnings and put it on a parlay that has no chance to hit. Thank you so much, Victor.
And we're sorry to hear about that deferral, but I heard Middle Tennessee State Community College is still accepting applications.
Go Bulls!
Entering the stage, please welcome Noah Islib. Noah is your average local Easton man who spends most of the time at the golf course or riding the bench at the ACF Arena. You can often find him eating his favorite pizza at the Villa and scoping out his future bar stool. He is often seen wearing Thorny Lee merch and acts as if he wasn't benched halfway through the golf season. He was commonly known for taking the reins as class president for 2 years, taking the class through war. Luckily, he was voted out of office and can finally live his glory days inside of the lacrosse net. Shockingly, Noah is continuing his academic career and after getting an 8 on a spelling quiz in second grade. For reference, his friend Ari got a 94. He would like to give a shout out to Polly Perrin for always letting him and his friends crash the Perrin pad, and to Ron Weasley for being his partner in their Fortune 500 business. If Noah wins, he will wrap the minivan in pictures of Mr. Flanagan's face and ride to OA in style. Lastly, he would like to thank Paul Bunyan for giving him this quality pine for his karate boards. Thank you so much, Noah.
Flanagan's face looked great on the side of a minivan, wouldn't it? Anyways, we're almost there, folks. Next up is John Kerry.
Where is it?
Here, oh. John Kerry plays football and does track and field. However, he likes to avoid the track portion and anything that contains running. Although he plans on continuing his football career, his real athletic dream is to be crowned the Nathan's Hot Dog Eating Contest champion. He's a classically trained professional dancer and a senior rec champion. In his free time, he enjoys long walks on the beach, playing the harmonica, and eating pie, in that order specifically. John hopes to win so he can have the prom tickets because he heard they're serving food there. Thank you, John, and I don't think you're the only person rooting for your dreams to come true.
Next up, we have Nick Farini. Nick Farini, commonly known as Zesty, is a superb male here at Oliver Ames. In his free time, he likes to help out the local Easton students by tutoring them in chemistry, where he excels academically. He also enjoys the freestyle, where he believes that he's much better than he really is. Nick plays baseball and football, where more people have continued to call him Zesty because of his kicking skills. He constantly gets made fun of for his unique sitting positions and the way that he holds a fork. As many of you know, he spends most of his nights crying about Juice WRLD and praising Rod Wave. Believe it or not, Nick's mother had to drop him here tonight since he had his license suspended for the past 3 months. 55 and a 40 isn't that bad, right? He would like to thank his friends, family, and most importantly, Russ Burnham for letting him live at his house for 3 nights a week. If Nick becomes Easton's finest, he won't have anyone to take to prom, but he plans to sell his free prom tickets and use that money to install waterside in the atrium. This performance has taken an incredible amount of hard work and dedication. He's put his blood, sweat, and tears into practicing over the last few weeks. All of his doubters have shot him down, but since the beginning, but tonight he's showing you why he is Easton's finest.
Honestly, it seems like Russ Burnham is the man to be. These contestants make him sound like Easton's finest.
Maybe we can get him up here at some point tonight.
Alrighty, everyone. Next, we have Jack Perrin. Jack, also known as Cam Perrin's little brother, is a three-sport athlete who takes pride in never skipping a night out. His passion in life is taking freshmen under his wing and showing him the ropes of high school. Jack has an undiagnosed speech impediment and looks up to Mike Tyson, who made having a speech impediment cool again. He brought sports goggles back in fourth grade, which started a trend among his fellow classmates. If he wins Easton's finest, he plans to sell his extra ticket since he is lonely and needs money on his debit card. In order to help the community, he will also donate his parking spot for someone who could better benefit from it. Jack wants to give a special shout out to Alicia Islib for giving him a below average mullet for over a year. In his free time, he enjoys long walks on the beach with his dog, listening to sad music at 3 a.m., and making intricate Minecraft worlds with Ben Reardon for hours on end. Fun fact, Jack would poop in secrecy in the handicapped stall in the English bathroom while the whole second floor is at lunch. Hold on, everyone. Did I mention that he's Cam Perrin's brother? By the way, I think we should all make a note to self. Do not go by the English bathroom during second lunch. Well, thank you, Jack. Wait, actually, hold on. Is it Cam? Wait, no, I was right. It's Jack.
Yes, thank you, Jack Perrin. And last but definitely not least, we have Jack Morley. Jack is a respectful young man who enjoys his free time by donating to charity and fighting for women's rights. He is an active feminist who loves writing poetry. Jack's hero is Gandhi. If Jack could have one wish come true, it would either be to end world hunger or to have super speed. You can often find Jack in the halls giving bullies a taste of their own medicine. After long, restless days of activism, Jack likes to take part in family-friendly activities with his friends at Bronson's house. He would like to shout out Russ Burnham for always giving him and his friends a place to play board games and Tickle Monster. When Jack grows up, he wishes to be a stay-at-home mom. His favorite color is blue, and his favorite food is whatever is on the table because he knows not to be greedy. He is also very good at multitasking. He even wrote this bio while driving. Thanks, Jack, and maybe you should stay away from multitasking.
All right, well, thank you, contestants, and that wraps up our sport category.
If you want to consider that sports.
We are now going to hand it off to our other co-hosts and get the talent portion started.
All right, starting off the talent portion of our show, tonight we have Rike doing something I'm sure all the folks in this room will love, pogo sticking. I wonder what great tricks he'll show us tonight.
You know, Amelia, something I've always wondered is how do you stop on a pogo stick?
You know, I'm not sure, but I guess we'll see in a bit. Give it up for Rike Oliveira. While we wait for Rike to come out, be sure that you check out our wonderful raffle tickets. We're selling some amazing things tonight, including a spa night. I don't know, I've never seen someone pogo stick live, have you?
No. I wonder what it's like.
I wonder too. I feel like you wouldn't be able to see anything. It would just be like, no, up and down. Yeah? Mm-hmm. Oh, here's the man himself.
Now, wasn't that something, folks? I mean, who goes on stage and forgets to tell the hosts what talent they're doing?
You know, I was thinking while he was doing his act, I'm not much of a singer. Never really been my thing.
I hear you, but you know who can sing and even play the guitar? Our next contestant.
Giving you a show, you're beautiful, cool, amazing, lovely, caring, kind, talented, skilled, did I say beautiful, hosts, could never compete with, our very own Mr. Michael Giambuso.
Can you hear me now?
Hey.
Cool. All right, I did a little sound check before, but I'm not sure it's, I don't know, we'll see. I drank so much water before this, I have to pee really bad. But that's okay. It's really dark, I'm wearing sunglasses, so I'm just picturing you all in your underwear. All right. Yeah. Oh, hold on. It works. They all work. All right. Nice. Thank you. And our next act. No, I'm just kidding. I'm kidding. I'm not going to do that. That was the last guy. I'm not doing that. All right.
You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You feel like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. At long last, love has arrived. And I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. Pardon the way that I stare. There's nothing else to compare. The thought of you leaves me weak. There are no words left to speak. And if you feel like I feel, please let me know this is real. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you.
Sing along if you know it.
Oh, I love you, baby. And if it's quite alright, I need you, baby, to warm the lonely nights. Oh, pretty baby, trust in me when I say, oh, pretty baby, don't toss and lie all night. Pretty baby, love you tight and I will love you, babe. Let me love you. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd feel like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. At long last, love has arrived. And I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. baby. Trust in me when I say, whoa, pretty baby, if you need me now, I love you, baby. Warm and lonely nights, my pretty baby. Trust in me when I say, everybody sing along, pretty baby. All the low da da, oh yeah, 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 yeah. Ba da 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 da, oh, love you, baby. Let me love you.
Thank you so much. See if I can shut it off too.
Amazing performance from Michael, truly a musician.
Truly a musician. He obviously has no experience in tech.
Next up, we have Andrew, who specifically asked me and my lovely host to tell you all that he will be doing a spelling bee with the words he struggles with the most. And he said, and I quote, it is the biggest battle of his life. Taking over the spot from the time that he made sure every student put their seat back and stacked at the end of third lunch.
That's an achievement if I've ever heard one. Members of the audience, please give it up for Andrew Zagami and his orthographic skills. Featuring Carly Gibson.
Is it on? Okay, it's on. This is the R spelling bee. Spell car.
Car. C-A-R. Car.
Your next word is Harvard.
Harvard. H-A-R-V-A-R. D. Harvard.
Your next word is Carly.
Carly. C. A. W. L. Y.
Almost. You know, you'll get it next time. Your next word is cartridge.
Cartridge. C. A. R. T R I D G E cartridge.
That was good. That was good. That was good. Your next word is afar.
Afar. A F A R. Afar.
Your next word is robbery.
Robbery. R-O-B-B-E-R-Y. Robbery.
I feel like you're going to like the next one. It's lawnmower.
My favorite. Lawnmower. L-A-W-N-M-O-W-E-R. Lawnmower.
Your next word is weed whacker.
Weed whacker. W E E D W A C K E R. Weed whacker.
That was good. Your next word is tractor.
Tractor. T R A C T O R tractor.
Next up is Sheridan.
Sheridan. S-H-E-W-I-D-A-N. Sheridan.
Almost, almost. And then your last word is rural.
Rural. R-U-R-A-L. Rural.
Whoa, Andrew, great job.
I don't know, Amelia. Some of those words seem like they could be on a third grade spelling quiz.
So you're telling me you could spell necessary right now?
Fair point. Good job, Andrew. For our next act, we have Olivia Stone singing I'm Still Standing by Elton John.
Testing? Yeah, it's six. There we go. Mm-hmm. You can never know what it's like. Your blood like winter freezes just like ice. And there's a cold, lonely light that shines from you. You'll wind up like the wreck you hide behind that mask you use. And did you think this fool could ever win? Well, look at me, I'm coming back again. I got a taste of love in a simple way. And if you need to know, I'm still standing. You just fade away. And don't you know that I'm still standing better than I ever did? It works. Looking like a true survivor. I'm feeling like a little kid. And I'm still standing after all this time. I'm picking up the pieces of my life without you on my mind. I'm still standing, yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm still standing, yeah, yeah, yeah. Once I never could have hoped to win. You're starting down the road, leaving me again. The threats you made were meant to cut me down. But if our love was just a circus, you'd be a clown by now. No, I'm still standing better than I ever did. I'm looking like a true survivor. I'm feeling like a little kid. And I'm still standing after all this time. I'm picking up the pieces of my life without you on my mind. I'm still standing, yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm still standing, yeah, yeah, yeah. And don't you know that I'm still standing better than I ever did? I'm looking like a true survivor. I'm feeling like a little kid. And I'm still standing after all this time. I'm picking up the pieces of my life without you on my mind. I'm still standing. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm still standing. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Come on. I'm still standing. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm still standing. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm still standing. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm still standing.
Beautiful voice. It's crazy how vocally talented most of our contestants are tonight. However, all the singing and music, you'd think we have a little dance party going on right now.
Trust me, Amelia, we're about to get all the dancing we need. Now, On the stage, we have Brian, a.k.a. B-Mitch, dancing to Toxic. As always, B-Mitch hit the floor with everything but grace.
If only everyone in this crowd knew that this wasn't his first time performing like this. You should see him at the pep rallies during the iconic dance battles.
Next up, we have another singer. I bet you can guess who it is. I'll give you a hint.
I have the name of the contestant on my note card, but sure, I'll give it a try.
So our next contestant, in my opinion, is the senior with the most school pride and spirit seen at almost all of the football games, basketball games, and leading the fan section for cheering the Tigers, one of the owners of the world-renowned Twitter account, Chirpin' Tigers.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Colby Tower.
Fly me to the moon, let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring's like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me. Fill my heart with song, let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you. Fill my heart with song. Let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you.
Fantastic job, Colby. Next up hitting the stage is Will, giving us a laugh with his stand-up comedy.
I guess you could say he will give us a great performance.
Let's leave the jokes to him tonight, Amelia.
Members of the audience, Will Burke.
Hello? How's everybody doing tonight? Everybody? Everybody all right? No, you're all left. So, I always hear everybody complaining about desk jobs. But I always think to myself, who wouldn't want to sit around all day? So, I was walking my dog earlier, and, yeah, I was walking my dog earlier, and I was halfway down the street, and I looked down, and I was like, this is a cat. And I do actually have a cat. Yeah, that fat large is so annoying. He's always rubbing against my leg. I always think, why are cats so weird? They're always coughing up hairballs and stuff. It's so sus. No, but seriously, I do hate my cat, so if anybody wants it, you can come and get it. But don't even get me started on coffee drinkers. Like what? If you don't have one sip of coffee, you're gonna fall asleep? So, I have a really beautiful brother, if there's any single ladies out there. Man, he's so handsome, I really wish I looked like him. Thank you.
Whoa. Well, didn't we get a kick out of that act?
We sure did. Who's up next?
Well, next up we have Victor doing a cheer routine. Hey, aren't performance. Wait a minute, Bea, aren't you a cheerleader? Isn't there a basketball game right now?
Yeah. Anyways, next up we have an incredible artist from the class of 23. Are you guys ready to see Noah Islip's painting skills?
Hello, everyone. I hope everyone is having a great night. I mean, these are quite some performances, but I am Pablo Picasso. So they're going to play the music, and it is a 2-minute timer, and at the end of the music, I will be done with my painting. Thank you. right, be for real. Can anyone tell what it is? All right. You guys weren't supposed to figure that out. Let me flip this around. Yeah, that's pretty good. What can I say? I mean, it's in my blood. Thank you all. I hope you have a great night. Last comment. If you want to buy it, just hit me up. Thanks.
Stunning work. What a painting.
Speaking of auctioning it off, who wants it tonight? Thanks, guys.
You know, with all these music acts, you'd think someone would have serenaded us by now. Performing for you all is John Kerry.
This thing go any higher? Yeah. Twist it. There we go. That good? Yeah.
And now the end is near. And so I face the final curtain. My friends, I'll say it clear. I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full. I've traveled each and every highway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do and saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it all, and I stood tall, and did it my way. I've loved, I've laughed and cried, I've had my fill, my share of losing. And now, as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that. And may I say, not in a shy way, oh no, oh no, not me. I did it my way. For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not to say the things he truly feels, yet not the words of one who kneels. The record shows I took the blows and did it my way. Yes, it was my way.
Awesome job, John.
Still can't believe a performance hasn't been dedicated to one of us and all of our hard work yet.
I'm sure we'll get one later, Amelia. But you know who is the who the next performance is dedicated to? Juice WRLD.
You heard it right, folks. Right now we have Nick guessing Juice WRLD songs in under 1 second.
Give it up for Nick Farini, aided by the wonderful Jenna Gilman.
How's it going, everybody? So, today, I will be guessing Juice WRLD songs in under 1 second. As many of you know, I'm a big Juice WRLD fan. Jenna here has a playlist of every single Juice WRLD song that has ever been released. She's gonna hit shuffle, and in 1 minute, I'm gonna guess as many Juice WRLD songs as I can. Mary has the timer, and when the first song plays, the timer will begin.
When are you starting?
Right now.
Okay, sweet.
Smile. Demons. I'm so. Bad boy. Real and really. Shorty. Fighting demons. Screw juice. Be with me. Nendia. End of the road. I want it. My life in a nutshell. Rider. Cigarettes. Wanted to LA. Hurt me. Lucid dreams. She's the one. Fighting demons. Armed dangerous. Wasted. Oh God.
Everyone, Nick got 22 Juice WRLD songs right in just under a minute. Very impressive, very impressive. Clearly, I think Nick is the number one Juice WRLD fan in America.
I can't believe he actually guessed all of those right.
I don't know if it's impressive or embarrassing.
Embarrassing or not, it's original.
Just like our next act, I hope everyone in the audience is excited for some ribbon dancing.
Rhythmic gymnastics, my favorite sport. Give a big round of applause for Jack Perrin.
Thank you.
Great work, Jack. Love the skill and grace you brought to the stage.
Speaking of stage, before our last performance of the night, we'd like to hear a huge round of applause because this is the first time in 4 years that this event has hit the OA stage.
It really is an honor to be hosting this event, especially with my best friends. Thanks for having us tonight, and a huge thank you to Ms. Visnoskis and Ms. Bailey, our judges, the tech crew, and all the people who came out here to support someone on stage or just for fun.
Now that all the sappiness is out of the way, I'm excited to introduce all of you to our final act of the night, Jack Morley playing the piano.
Alright, so I'm gonna be singing a song, and if you know the lyrics, feel free to sing along.
Sing us a song tonight, but we're all in the mood for
Great job, Jack. Now that concludes the talent portion of the night.
And now we're going to hand it off to our co-host, Marion Liv, for the Q&A portion of our show tonight.
Contestants, and thank you, Amelia and Bia. Now we're going to head onto a quick intermission before we go into a Q&A portion. So it's just brief. If you want to use the restrooms, there's a concession stand out there, and we'll be back in about 5 minutes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome back, everybody. Okay. Welcome in, everybody. Hope you're all settling again.
Kiko.
All right, our contestants are more than ready to answer some questions. We'll now be moving on to our Q&A segment of the show.
I'm sure you're all dying to get to know a little what's going on inside these contestants' minds.
I'm not exactly sure that I want to know what's going on in these people's minds, but let's see how these fine seniors answer these deep, deep questions.
Me too. So how this is going to work is the escort's going to pull a question out of a hat, and then the contestant's going to answer as best they can.
All right, sounds simple enough. Let's get into it.
Thank you, John. Up first, we have Rike with his escort, Josiah, picking a question.
Passes down the line.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Rike, your question is, if your life had a theme song, what would it be and why?
I'd probably have to say Eye of the Tiger because I just love Oliver Ames High School.
All right, Michael, with Mitchell, his escort.
Thank you.
If you could have dinner with one person, dead or alive, who would you choose?
Well, honestly, before tonight, I think my answer would be completely different. But after seeing Jack Morley play Piano Man, I just, speechless, I can't. That guy, I will eat food with that guy.
All right, next up we have Andrew Zagami with his escort, Carly Gibson. All right, Andrew, your question is, who was your favorite teacher at OA and why?
Mr. Cahill, because he hangs out with me and he helps me with so much, like work, and he's just a great guy.
All right. Next up is Olivia Stone with her escort, Lauren Schleifer. Sorry, it's a little twisted. Would you rather travel back in time or into the future?
Ooh, that's hard. probably back in time. I really like history, so it would be cool to experience it.
Good answer, good answer. All right, next up we have Brian Mitchell with his escort, Brandon Burke. All right, your question is, what era or time period do you wish you got to experience?
Yo, like 600 AD or like whatever. Or yeah, no, BC, I meant BC. Yeah. Because I want to see dinosaurs.
Oh, interesting. Very interesting. All right, here we have Colby Tower and Sophia Byron.
That's a good one. Feel it.
If you could repeat one grade, what would it be and why?
Wait, can you repeat the question?
If you could repeat one grade, what would it be and why?
I would probably say second grade. That's when I had my first love. It was one of my teachers. I'm not going to say who. But we had a great time, and I would do anything to go back to that.
I'm sure we're all wondering who that teacher is.
I can't believe I just said
all right, next up we have Will Burke with his escort, Bella Carney. Will, are you your parents' favorite child? Why or why not? If you're not, who is?
No. My brother is, because like I said earlier, he's very handsome. Yeah.
I'm sure we should bring him up on stage. Everyone wants to see what he looks like now. All right, here we have Victor Amira with Katie Ivanovsky.
Thank you.
Victor, if you had a movie created about your life, who would you cast a play yourself?
I would have to say Danny DeVito because he's around my height.
Good to know. All right, here we have Noah Islip and his escort, Tyler Delamere. All right, Noah, what was the most embarrassing moment of your life?
I'm going to have to say tonight. I mean, I came up here in a karate suit, chopped boards that were half broken, and then I came up here in a painter's hat, acted like Pablo Picasso, and that was it.
All right, no, you didn't have to expose yourself there, but... All right, here we have John Carey and Emma Donovan. John, if you were stuck on a deserted island and could bring one person and one food, what would that be?
Well, for my food, I would definitely have to say hot dogs, because as you heard before, it's my dream to win the Nathan's hot dog eating competition. And for a person, I wouldn't bring anyone, because I don't want to share my hot dog.
All right, here we have Nick Franey and Jenna Gilman. All right, Nick. Tell us your best pickup line.
My best pickup line? Yep. You may fall from the sky. You might even fall from a tree. But the best way to fall is in love with me.
Wow. Okay, Nick. All right, here we have Jack Perrin and Jordan Grimaldi. All right, Jack. What is the best piece of advice you've ever received?
The best piece of advice I've ever received is probably, don't eat the yellow snow. That's no good. It's kind of gross.
All right, and finally, we have Jack Morley and his escort, Jordan Young. All right, Jack, for a day, if you could live in the shoes of one away teacher, who would it be and why? And what would you do?
That's a good question. I'd say Mr. Pamela, because sometimes I wonder what he does when he goes home. And I feel like he does a lot of interesting things.
Good answer, good answer. All right, now we're going to be moving on to our pose things. And this is when, I didn't know how to explain it. Now our judges are going to be tallying up who's going to win, and we're going to see our winners. Hold the curtain.
Lily Ball! I will.
All right, as Mary said earlier, while the judges are deliberating, we're going to take this moment to have a little photo op. All right, bouncing onto the stage again, Rike. Wow, look at those poses.
Can't you see those smiles from a mile away?
Your very own Michael, not just a musician, but a style icon with his unforgettable leather jackets.
Sorry. Next up, we have Andrew. Surprised it's not, he's not rolling in on his lawnmower.
Dazzling.
Mm-hmm.
have the wonderful Olivia Stone, the only lady contestant tonight.
Her and her escort are making history. Here we have Beamitch and Brandon. Can you name a better duo?
Now we have Colby and Sophia slaying the stage. Always favorite couple. Look at those lovebirds.
Next up, we have Will and Bella, both looking super spiffy. Make sure you sign up for tonight's raffle so you get the chance to win all sorts of prizes, including a spa bag, so you can look just as good as them.
All right, Victor and his escort, Katie. Maybe he'll end up victorious tonight.
Here comes Noah and our very own Van Gogh and his muse, Tyla.
Troy Bolton, John and Emma.
About to strike some fierce poses are Nick and Jenna.
Have Jack Perrin, whose rhythmic gymnastic skills that of Lily Mizuno.
Next up, we have OA's personal Mozart, Jack Morley.
And for a surprise photo op, we have us, your wonderful, amazing, talented hosts. I forget our other hosts helping us tonight, Liv and Mary.
Next category is going to be moving on to the placing, but we're just waiting for our judges to finish tallying up their votes, so just bear with us.
We're quickly going to take a big group photo with all our contestants.
Get a closer.
Hello. You guys can get a little closer and make it look like you like each other. He can't get all of you guys in one straight line, so. Oh my god. Have you never taken a group photo before?
You have to do the sashes.
Okay, and here's the moment you've all been waiting for. After careful considerations, our judges have decided this decision was definitely a hard one to make. Before we announce a winner and runner-ups, we'd like to thank all of our contestants for their hard work.
Okay, drum roll please.
The second runner-up for Easton's Finest is Michael Jambuso.
In second place, we have John Carey.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your class of 2023's Easton's Finest. Congratulations to Jack Morley.
Just have one more round of applause for all of our contestants tonight.
As we're taking a quick pause for these photos, I just want to remind you all to go buy a raffle ticket and win some awesome prizes.
Unfortunately, that is the end of our 2023 Easton's Finest competition. Thank you to everyone who can make it out tonight. We're so happy to have so many people here who are dedicated to keeping up this long-standing tradition.